When I first said I will fight drugs in 6 months, I thought it was like in Davao. You can either coerce, intimidate, or bribe them, or give them money. I said, lumabas kayo ng Davao, doon kayo magkalat sa Luzon at sa ibang lugar. Huwag dito sa Davao. Naniniwala naman ang mga ulol at we were able to attain a sense of normalcy in the city. Yun ho ang totoo. There are people charged with corruption and even going to prison for just maybe not telling the truth in their tong assets and liabilities. Nakukulong itong mga police were knowing their thing, their drugs. They were the manufacturers and they were the distributor of drugs. When I became president, I asked De La Rosa. He was the chief of police of my city. I promoted him direct to being PNP chief. 4-star na kaagad automatic. But I told him and the others, look for the enemies. Look where they are. And if you find them, destroy the apparatus. Destroy all, from the manufacturers to the peddlers, because we are fighting a drug war that was being participated in the business by 9 generals of the PNP. Kayan ang sakit sa lugo. I did not know that I was fighting my own government. Customs and everyone else were facilitating the importation of drugs. And one importation, as you can see it every night on TV, the police now sees about almost a billion worth of drugs every day. And if you look at the 888, there are about 1,000 Filipinos arrested every day by the police in connection with drug trafficking. And that is why I go crazy looking at the situation. They are still around. We do not have the laboratories now because nawala na sila. At itong naiwan ngayon are doing the importation. The citizens of another country cook their shabu in their tawag nito in their tugboat or something, and they threw out the product in contained in the plastic bags and with a GPS attached to the contraband so that the importers here could find them easily. That is how we are fighting, almost losing a battle against drugs. And now, the Sinaloa gangsters of Mexico and the triad of Laos in that area, they are busy cooking. And we have the Filipinos here with nothing in their mind except to destroy a nation, distributes them. That is what I said. I've been asked the question, and several times I gave the answer. I am a Filipino, and I love my country. I do not want my country in disarray because of drugs. I do not want families break up and become dysfunctional. Yun ang masakit sa akin. When there, if you want to destroy a family, look for a way of the member or a resident of that family home. Biglang may druga. Pag nandyan na yung druga at they are hooked, and that is the end. Sometimes families are separated because of drugs, becomes dysfunctional, at yung mga masawa magpunta doon sa abroad, ika nga, to look for jobs. And you know, in the Middle East, I am not attributing it to any particular country. But there are tribes in the Middle East who are employing our Filipina citizens, and they are uniform. Everybody who comes here home asks them how many hours of sleep they have. They said it's only 3 to 4 hours. And the food is hogwash. And the sacrifice, because they send money to the families back home, and thinking all the time that the money was spent usefully, only to realize when she comes home that that family has already dispersed to nowhere. Bakit yan? Because itong mga drugista sa baba, itong peddlers, itong basurero, tawag, it's a street lingo, they look for families na may mga nanay, tatay nagtrabaho, ang tatay or nanay nagtatrabaho sa abroad. And to think na iniiwan nila ang mga anak nila kung saan-saan na lang, to their neighbors, at the tender age of 3 to 4, 5, it breaks your heart. Iiwan lang nila sa kapitbahay kung walang mga relatives. And then, when they come back 4 years after, they now realize that their young sons and daughters have gone into prostitution because of drugs. And their boys or their female, male are nowhere to be found, and into the drug business also. Yun ang pinakamasakit. Masakit sa akin na ang Pilipina pumunta doon para magtrabaho, because sexual abuse in some tribes in the Middle East have this notion that if you are a slave or you are a paid person working for them, sexual abuse becomes part of the territory. Kaya dyan ako pumuputok at nakakita ko yung mga pamilya na sira. And to think that they labored without sleep, eating, I said, garbage, and not being allowed to go to their own church to pray, Well, that is prohibited by them. And we have been, just because of their money that they get, we just look the other way around. But still being, you know, bothered every night and day, what will happen to the next succeeding group of... That is why I have in this speech, I talk about slavery. Pero yan, pag-prank ako, I never deny. And the ICC can record it. Those who destroy my country, I will kill you. And those who destroy the young people of our country, I will kill you. Talagang nangyayarihin kita. Because I love my country. You can do it the legal way, but it would take you months and years. And you know what? The statistics I just learned the other night, that plenty of those who are in the middle class have been released from prison despite the fact that they are charged of trafficking, which is non-bailable, and most of them are out. Babae, pati lalaki, ang kaso.